Ladies and gentlemen, here she is, the second winner of our film scoring contest, Endlich Allein, Maria Lazareva.
Hi, Andreas. Thank you so Hello. Much for inviting me. So nice to see you.
Здравствуйте, Maria.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. I'm super happy. Like, I was so lucky to be chosen the second one. The entries were absolutely amazing. So I'm very honored. It's great honor and inspiration for me. So thank you so much for this contest. It means a lot to us musicians.
Your entry was amazing too, of course.
Thank you.
Thank you for participating and thank you for your time. Before we get into your score for our contest and a few other topics, of course, I would like to briefly introduce you.
Maria Lazareva started learning music and playing the violin when she was 6 years old. She graduated from the Moscow Tchaikovsky Conservatory and got her master's degree in the Karlsruhe University of Music. Her first recital as a soloist was at the age of 11. Maria performs regularly as a soloist with ensembles and orchestras at various concert venues in her country and abroad. She has been the constant soloist of chamber ensemble Eccellente. Maria's repertoire spans from Baroque music to the pieces of modern composers. Six violin albums by Maria Lazareva are available on main digital platforms. From 2023, she is a leader of an instrumental rock band. Maria is a prize winner of several violin and composing competitions.
The second winner of our contest, Maria, how did you find a contest? How did you find about it?
Actually, it's my second contest from you guys. The first one was the Halloween Hangover. I was really enjoying composing for that one. I didn't win, but I really wanted to try this one because I'm really interested in scoring for films, for videos. And I really want to practice like writing some scores, especially like horror style, something like very dark. So it was a very interesting challenge for me. And I think some of the VI forum members posted it on the forum, and that's how I found it.
Okay, yeah, thanks. What was your approach to score?
First, I think I just watched many horror movies just to get inspiration and to see how the music might work or might
really,
not work.
Really?
Really? Yes. Yes, it was like some like scary evenings just watching in headphones, listening for the like special effects the composers used, like what the moments can be like used, what the silence moments can be used. So like it was inspiring. Yeah, and then I just like tried different things. First, I have a different beginning music. It had more like sad and more strings there in the beginning, but I changed it like completely later. I hope it's better now. Yeah, but I just like tried first to sketch which mood I will use. And in the very end, this jazzy thing, I was trying to show what the main character was thinking, both the woman and the man. So he was like thinking that's the final date he was dreaming about, and the woman was like very terrified, and we have this pitch sounding like above this jazzy style.
Have you packed already?
Yes, baby.
Where are you traveling to?
As I said, our secret.
If I have questions?
No calls.
I love you. See you soon.
I'm pleased.
See you in 2 weeks.
Bye-bye.
Alone at last. Mark? What's this shit?
Now be a good girl and drink this.
You're still here?
Yes, why not?
Can I speak to Franca for a minute?
I'm alone, man. Franca is on vacation.
Thought she was going with you, man.
She wanted to be alone. Horror film.
Thank you.
You choose a very, very special approach at the end. No one else has had the perspective of the man. Yeah.
Well,
it's very interesting, and it was. I like it. I like it very, very much. It's great.
Thank you. I showed it for my friend. He's like a sound producer. He said, like, this is a very strange ending you chose. And I said, the contest jury wanted some surprise moment. So I thought maybe this will be the surprise moment.
Yeah. You got it. you got it.
Thank you.
What equipment did you use? What software, what libraries? Can you tell a bit about this?
Yeah, mostly I used Omnisphere. Like, it's like lots of things and effects for this style. I think you can use there. So it was like very useful. And yeah, some of the like Sonuscore, like for the piano, I used Chroma. For the strings, I used some Spitfire. So mostly like these effects. Mm. I think some of the contact like libraries for like the ending, like the factory library, contact factory library for the ending. They have like these jazz instruments there.
Okay, interesting. You, as a violin player, and a very good one, I have to say.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes, I started like playing the violin since I was a child. Like, I was born in a music family. My grandpa is quite a prominent oboist in my country, so he put me like from the very beginning in the music schools. He was like patronizing me to be like a solid musician, so I am very thankful to my family and still playing.
Yes, of course, you're still playing. Oh, we come to this a little bit later. What would you say? Would you say that as a classically trained and versatile violinist, you have an advantage over composers without explicit musical training?
Yeah, actually, I never like really practiced, like learned how to compose, just like the basic harmony, like music theory we studied as violinists, instrumentalists in the school. But I always enjoyed composing, because when I played the violin, I always felt like the music of the famous composers is beautiful, but it doesn't really reflect my own feelings that I want to express. And I really wanted to create something my own that really can reflects my own feelings when I play it. And I think it's the best part of being a composer is you can create your own unique worlds that never exist before, and you just do it on your own with your own hands. So I think that's amazing.
I think that connects us and our community on this channel to create own musical worlds. Yeah.
Yeah, to create something that never exists before, and you're just like the creator of something completely new. I think it's wonderful.
There are people, they say creativity doesn't need any education. Do you think so?
It's a tough question. I think now we have so many different styles in music that sometimes music theory can give you a little disadvantage. Sometimes I notice the people among my friends who compose music don't have education in music, but they have such fresh ideas, like such unique approach. For example, in like ambient style electronic music. So sometimes, even if you don't have like classical music training, you can create beautiful and unique stuff. So I think the music theory definitely can help you, but yeah, it's difficult to answer.
Maria as chess player.
Oh, gosh.
Tell us about Maria. Oh. Tell us about your passion for playing chess.
Oh, gosh. It's funny that you like brought it up. Just like some fun time to relax some music. And I think chess can be like music. There's like a beginning, the intro, the opening in chess. There's like the middle part, the main part of the music, like the middle game, and like the final part, the end game, Endspiel, to play. It's just like my time to like relax my mind, to go in a different world, and to have some exciting feelings of like winning or losing or competing. I just love competing sometimes. Yeah, but actually I'm not so good, although I won a couple of like little like amateur competitions in chess, but it was just for fun.
Oh, I think she is not as bad as it sounds now. I read you play around 1,800 ELO.
It's a Leach chess. It's online for like it's like online, so my real rating is much lower. Yeah, unfortunately, I don't have much time to play now because I'm so busy with like the music things. But I hope I will have more time in the summer to play a bit more.
If I played against you, you would win, I think. My ELO is around 1,300.
That's great.
And if you are so good as I think you are, I would have a really good chance when I have a really good day and you are exhausted after a violin concerto. Then I might have a little chance.
No, I think you are great. Like, I haven't played for quite a while.
You are a band leader of a classical rock band. Is that right?
Instrumental rock band. Yes, we have two cellos, so like one violin, a bass guitar, and a drums. So actually, yeah, it was like coming to random, like a friend of our family, he's a concert producer. He called me last summer and told, do you know any cellos? Like I'm launching like a new instrumental rock band. And that time I was like looking for like new jobs, like new projects, because the school I was teaching closed and I was like free to some new adventures. So I said, why don't you like invite me? Like I would really love to play. And actually I had some experience in playing metal band when I was studying in Germany. So I really wanted to join again. So now we almost like a year. We play like many covers. We play like classical pieces in rock styles. So, and I mainly like arrange all the songs for this band and also play the violin.
A little bit composer is always in the air. Ladies and gentlemen, Maria is also a painter.
It's also my like free time, like nothing really serious. But I always like loved painting when I was a child, like extra free time. I like painted a lot. Like I have like a little picture painted by me behind me, like with oil. But again, if I have time, I really enjoy doing that just to relax and put on some nice music in the background and just like dive in my own world for a little bit.
Great, great.
Thank you.
You are a composer, obviously, and a very good one, and a very versatile one. When did you start composing with computers and libraries?
I think it was around like 15 years ago, but actually I had a huge break after that. So I think it was in 2007 when I first saw the video games, and I was amazed by what kind of beautiful music there can be, like symphonic orchestra, epic choirs, like mixed with a cool electronic. And I really, really wanted to do that, to write for video games as a composer for films. And I started learning doing that by my own. I had Cubase first. I like purchased my first like East-West Library orchestra, and I I think I learned a couple of months how to like put music notes there and export the WAV file. And I started like sending to the game developers like my emails that I'm a composer, please hire me, I can do music for you. And actually like one of the game companies like asked me to do some music, first like very small projects, but then we ended up I think for 5 years. And there was like a very nice RPG game and then like an online mobile game. But still it was like it was like kind of like very rough. I didn't know much about mixing that time. I didn't know like many things there, and I think at one moment I felt completely stuck. I called off one of the game projects saying like, I'm sorry, I think I'm not good enough to do that project. I need some time to like to learn more. I tried to find some teachers just to be better. But actually, it was not much luck that time. So I gave up on my dream to become a game composer for a total 10 years. I didn't compose at all for 10 years until the pandemic. At that time, I decided to come back to my biggest dream to compose again. And luckily, at that time, I found like a really nice tutors who helped me with like lots of tech stuffs and like about mixing. And I felt like a really new start, a really fresh start to keep going again. And now I'm composing again. That's I'm very happy to.
Is it true that most of your plugins and libraries have been switched off due to the special situation in your country?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's very challenging for composers nowadays in my countries. We can't buy like new plugins, new libraries, and some of the subscriptions and even paid libraries were cancelled. So for some time, we had to rely on free libraries or to find some friends who can buy for us, like with international cards. So yeah, it's very challenging, but we try our best. And I think with these difficult situations, we cherish more the simple things. Yeah.
You are very keen to experiment. I know. I've seen it. Mm-hmm. One would think that a violin player would reach for pencil, paper, and piano when composing, but you also have other equipment that you master virtuously. People, take a look at this. Yeah, tell us about your push 2 experience. It's not easy to play it in this virtuous way you did.
It was completely random. Like I found push 2 actually in the school I was teaching. So one of the colleagues just showed me, hey, like here's the one thing we have here, like push to maybe you'll be interested to try it out. And yeah, it was not easy to learn. Luckily, I had some friend who like showed me how to use it. So like I tried to experiment, and it's really like different way you approach this thing. Like you have different way of thinking, but luckily I have like Ableton Live, and it's like more easy to connect it with this program. Yeah, I wish I can use it more like in the future when I have opportunities for live performances.
We are coming to the end of our conversation. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you very much for your time, which
you
don't have in abundance right now. I know you are currently on a concert tour, right?
Yeah, this weekend I'm playing in St. Petersburg. So I have two concerts. So the first one will be with the pianist. We have a piece by Beethoven for violin piano the whole evening, yes. And the second one I'll play with a chamber orchestra. We have a very interesting program. The first part will be Vivaldi Four Seasons, and the second part will be the 20th century composers like Scott Rutenberg, Arvo Pärt, and Zwassmann.
Such a concert tour, isn't that totally exhausting?
Yes, a little bit. Like I think like a couple of days ago, I traveled to Belgorod. It's the border city near Ukraine, and the situation there is very dangerous. Like it's daily like airstrikes, and you should be like very careful going outside. And I encountered one of the attacks there. So yeah, it was a bit like exhausting with all the like, nervousness there. But the people there were like very supportive, very kind. But I really enjoy doing that. I love traveling and share with people my music and meet new people there. Like it's the best life I can imagine.
What are your future plans?
Right now I'm attending the course for game audio. Actually, I really want to go back into my biggest dream to be a game composer. So there, like I'm learning some special programs for game composers like Wise and FMod, and I'm also learning a bit of sound design there. So I think I'll finish it in June, and after that I really try to pursue more of the projects for films and games, so I'll try my best to go there.
Do you have any tip for young aspiring composers to get into this scene?
I think you would agree that being a composer and musician is very challenging and tough. You doubt yourself all the time. Luckily, there were people who inspired me not to give up and keep going again. So I think it's very important not to give up, to keep learning, to keep enjoying what you do, and waiting for like, not waiting, but trying out to know people in the industry, to get people know you, your music, and the luck will come, the lucky moment will come, and step by step, the connections will gather together and you'll get there. I'm still in the process, but like I'm happy like with all the great opportunities I already have with music. It brings joy. I think it's very important to like enjoy doing music and sharing your music with other people.
Maria, I had great fun with you. Our conversation was your prize, but I feel rewarded now. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much. It's such amazing and great experience. Like I'm very happy. It's a great opportunity. I enjoyed a lot this contest. I'm looking forward to your new projects, and I think you thought you will have new contests coming up. I'll definitely try to participate, and I encourage all the people to take part in this contest. It's really fun.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Maria.
Thank you so much. My
pleasure.
Спасибо.